Hello, this is Dr. Lindsay again. And in this video, I want to go through some examples with you, kind of like case studies. And we'll look at the economy and we'll try to figure out what's going on in the economy, why it is the way it is, and then try to figure out what should be done to get us out of that situation, either by the Fed, monetary policy, or fiscal policy. Okay, so first example. Let's say that the economy is a little bit less than potential. We're running where output here is less than potential output. That means inside the PPF. This is also known as a negative output gap. And let's say unemployment is 6.5%, something consistent with being inside the PPF, which means, you know, on the PPF, full employment is somewhere between 4 and 6. So inside the PPF would be something more than that. We'll say 6.5. Let's say inflation is 1%, so a little bit lower than what central banks and economists would like to see. And the federal funds rate is 5%, that overnight lending rate that banks charge each other to borrow money. Let's draw this kind of situation here using the aggregate demand and aggregate supply model. So on this axis is inflation, and down here is GDP. And we have this aggregate supply curve, the short run, aggregate supply curve. It is upward sloping or kind of flat in the short run. And we've got a downward sloping aggregate demand curve. And at the intersection here at equilibrium, we can say that that equilibrium is at 1% inflation and output is less than potential. So that means that potential has to be over here somewhere. We're inside the PPF. Now, what could Congress, what could be done for fiscal policy here? The economy is less than potential. We're inside the PPF. Well, we could have some fiscal policy, which is done by Congress. And that would be to increase government spending or lower taxes. And that will shift the aggregate demand curve to the right. What about monetary policy? That's handled by the Fed. What could they do? Well, first, let's just take a look at the situation and say, well, why are we in this situation? The federal funds rate is 5%. Inflation's 1%, unemployment 6.5. Full employment is around 5%. Optimal inflation is around 2%. What is the real interest rate? So remember Fisher equation, I equals R plus pi. The federal funds rate is a nominal interest rate. So little I is 5%. Inflation's 1%. That means the real interest rate is 4%. Now that's kind of high. Remember, R star is maybe 2% or 1%, maybe even less than that right now. So a real interest rate of 4% in the economy means that interest rates are kind of high. And the Fed is probably has a contractionary stance. That might explain why the economy is inside the PPF, less than potential. It might also explain why the inflation rate is kind of low. So what should the Fed do? They need to move back towards a neutral stance or an expansionary stance, depending on how much this negative output gap is. Is it a bad recession or what? So the FOMC will get together at their meeting and say, well, you know, they focus on interest rates and their policy instrument is the federal funds rate. So they'll say, well, let's lower the federal funds rate. This will stimulate the economy. Lower it to 4.75. Problem is they don't know how much to lower it really. They lower it a little bit and they see what happens. See what happens at their next meeting. And if we're in the same boat, 4.5. Maybe next time, 4.25. They try not to make too fast of moves. They try not to shock the economy. They try to be transparent in what they're going to be doing and letting everyone know, yeah, we're going to be lowering interest rates here. As they lower interest rates, nominal interest rates, that will lower real interest rates, increase investment spending, increase aggregate demand. So this aggregate demand curve will shift to the right and output will go up. And over time, it'll take a little bit longer, the inflation rate will go up. So by lowering the federal funds rate, they can move back to a neutral stance or lower it enough to move to a expansionary stance. And that should meet both of their mandates that they have, the full employment mandate and the stable prices mandate, by increasing output, which will lower the unemployment rate. And it'll also move us closer to our 2% optimal inflation rate. So in this case, what the Fed does is simply say, yeah, we're in a recession. We don't have to worry about inflation. That's a little bit low. We'll lower interest rates. It takes money to do that. That's met by increasing the money supply. That increase in the money supply and lowering interest rates stimulates aggregate demand, stimulates the economy. GDP increases, and over time, inflation will rise too. Now let's take another example, another little case study to analyze the economy and figure out what kind of a shape it's in and what can be done about it. Okay, example number two. Let's say the economy is greater than potential. So why is greater than potential GDP? This is known as a positive output gap. And let's say unemployment is 3.7%. It's got to be something that would match being outside the PPF. So something better than 4-6. Now being outside the PPF is, I told you at the beginning of the course that it's not possible, but it actually is possible for a short period of time. It's not sustainable though to be outside the PPF. And let's say the inflation rate is 4%, a little bit higher than what the central bank would like to see because their optimal is around 2%. And let's say the federal funds rate, that short-term interest rate, is 2%. That interest rate that's very short-term, the overnight rate that banks charge each other to borrow money to meet their reserves. That is the federal funds rate. So let's draw this first using aggregate demand, aggregate supply. We have our short run aggregate supply curve, aggregate demand curve. And at the current equilibrium, inflation's 4%. And output is greater than potential. So that means potential has to be like back here somewhere. Now, why might we be in that kind of position where we're out beyond the PPF, the economy's really hot, inflation's kind of high? Well, first let's figure out what the real interest rate is, R. Remember the Fisher equation, I equals R plus pi. The nominal interest rate, little I, is 2%. The inflation rate is 4%. That means little r, the real interest rate, has to be negative 2%. A negative 2% real interest rate means that the Fed is being very expansionary, very accommodative. That's another word term for expansionary. Because regardless of what R star is, you know, whether it's between 0 and 1 or 2, a negative 2% in the economy, negative real interest rates, really, you can make a very good case that the Federal Reserve, the central bank, is being very expansionary. And that might explain why the economy is so hot, why it's actually out beyond the PPF. GDP is greater than potential. Might also explain why there is a high inflation going on at 4%, because in order to keep interest rates that low, it takes money. So they're increasing the money supply, keeping interest rates low. Those interest rates, low interest rates, are stimulating the economy, keeping its way out on the PPF doing well, but it's leading to some inflation over time. So we can make a case here that what we need to do, the Fed needs to move us more towards a neutral stance, or maybe even a contractionary stance to reduce that inflation rate, bring it down a little bit. So to do that, the Fed is going to need to do something to shift aggregate demand to the left. They've got their dual mandates, maximum sustainable employment, but stable prices. So they've got to concentrate on this high inflation rate and bring that down to have their, to meet their definition of stable prices. So how do they do that and increase aggregate demand? Well, they'll need to start raising the federal funds rate. So it's at 2, they need to move it up to 2.25 or 2.5, then maybe 2.75 and 3%. And they'll do it slowly, generally, watch what's going on. And that will move us back down towards potential output. And over time, the inflation rate will fall. So the only way they can really bring down the inflation rate is by reducing aggregate demand and lowering output. If they do it too much, they contract too much and raise these interest rates too high, that aggregate demand will fall to the point where it's below potential, and then they end up causing a recession. It'll bring down inflation. That's going to take some time to bring down the inflation, but if they're not careful, it'll cause a recession, have a Fed-induced recession like they did